toast.
As I just crushed you. Oh no, Ponzi did too.
Come on.
It's the most fishing I've done in the last 10 years of my life. There you go.
Oh wow, it really doesn't work like that.
Current music crush, Cardi B.
It's like a personality crush. Dude,
no. Your dream collaborator of all time, dead or alive. Yeah, I'd say Martin Hannett, who was the producer of Joy Division.
The most fun thing you did in your 4-year hiatus?
Built a school in Nepal with like a group of friends from LA. After every day, like when we were done working in the field, we'd play soccer, and like one of the days I played soccer with the kid, like, and they were so good. But my friend, who's British and like also grew up playing like soccer, like new footy, he had a corner kick and he did this like perfect corner kick, and I saw it coming and I turned my hat around backwards and I jumped up like with all the Nepali kids, were all fighting for the ball, and I just did this like Drogba like header into the upper 90s, and all the kids were like, oh, and I was just like, yeah, you know, like I got their respect.
Wow.
And the gym to you, hell. When I was in high school, and I think that was the only time I really had to go to, I was like forced to go to the gym. Yeah, I really wanted the gym. I like being outdoors.
I could see you with like logs on your back doing like the Rocky training sequence.
Yes.
Just like being like pulling your like tractor with like a rope around your waist.
Okay. Describe Sacred Hearts Club in one sentence collectively.
Solidarity.
Solidarity, joy.
There's a real Sacred Hearts Club. What's the first rule of the club? Never discuss the rules.
Never talk about Sacred Hearts Club. Rule number two. Refer to rule number one.
No yelling on the bus.
Rule number three. Dude, I was gonna say that.
No thinking about yelling on the bus.
Favorite song to perform live from Sacred Hearts Club?
Mine's Lotus Eater.
Loyal like Sid and Nancy.
Hey, the band.
Next. What albums play on your tour bus regularly?
Probably Beach Boys.
New Imperial Pink record.
Oh, yeah. That's a good record.
I've been playing the new Pond record. We've been playing that a bit.
The most pumped up kicks today in your opinion?
Like the coolest kicks.
We've got some cool creepers on right now.
These aren't docks.
I would love to get a pair of dock creepers though.
Biggest audience pet peeve when you're performing on stage?
Checking their phone.
Yeah. Or just even filming.
I feel like I've been starting to embrace that more. If I can like grab, I've been like grabbing fans' phones and like and filming stuff
that
they normally wouldn't be able to film. Everybody's when you got one hand in the air, you can't like clap, you can't dance, you can't. So it's like it's just a crowd of people going like this. There was a moment where it was like really driving me crazy, but then I've kind of just evolved past that. I'm just like, you know what? Like that's just like that's how they want to enjoy it. It's like, who are we to like tell them how to enjoy our show? You know, flattering too in a way. They want to do it because they can go home and watch it later and show their friends. I've been guilty of doing it too. Like I've seen like my favorite bands, and I'm not gonna stand there like this forever. But it's like I'll catch a little bit of it and then put it away.
Former music
crush, Madonna.
Share.
Share. Oh, show meal.
Shirley Manson. That was still in the previous one.
I thought you were saying Roche.
What was the question?
Your post-show meal.
I like ate at some local restaurant last night. I had avocado toast. It was the only place that was open. We flew in at like midnight.
The same thing back on tour. It's great to be back in Singapore. It's you know, I think we all learned. Just seeing you in person is special. Had a little more time today, so cruising around and seeing the clouds for us.
How did the name Sacred Hearts Club come about? And what did it mean?
It was something that a friend of mine said, like randomly, when we were kind of just talking about art and like people that kind of lived outside of like societal norms through history, like artists. And I was like, what is that? What's that essence? What's the essence of what that's called? And she's like, Sacred Hearts Club. And so then we kind of like, it kind of branched out. It became this thing, kind of became this mantra, and then kind of infected like a bunch of my groups of friends in LA, where they started calling themselves the Sacred Hearts Club, and like other people started like kind of embracing it. And then it, you know, started as a song and then ended up as the album. Thank you.
Right now.
Thank you, Spirit of Jenna, for guiding us all. Some only kids were on this.
Yeah, that's right. I play tambourine, I play the shaker, stick,
Belltree.
Yeah, Belltree.
Play a really nice Belltree, yes. Yeah, nice touch.
China. I have like multiple China symbols and Spanish symbols.
What's one thing about customers and
agents? Showing up too early when we're like, when we have to be there, especially like playing like Reading and Leeds in England, like where it's like we have to drive a couple hours from London to get there, so it's like you just driving, and like once you're there, it's like having to listen to, like, basically you can't hear, like when you're in your green room, like you can't hear the music clearly, so you just hear the bass just rattles the room, so it's just like. Miss the Grammys, but it's also, we've gotten to a point to where I think we all kind of agree that like it's not really something that we've watched really the last few years, because it's just. It's something that you get like super excited about. You're like, it's the Grammys again, you know? It's gonna be like this really cool musical collaborations, and it's gonna be really fresh, and like art is gonna get rewarded. And then like every year you're just like, what the hell did I just spend 3.5 hours of my life watching? So excited about the Academy Awards, like every year. And I'm like, the Grammys should be so much more exciting than the Academy Awards, because it's music. You know, it's like the Academy Awards is exciting. They somehow make that exciting revolving around actors giving speeches for something that they've already accomplished. You know, but the Grammys, it's like you have an opportunity to do something like live in the moment that's never been seen before or done before, and I feel like a lot of times they kind of play it safe. So I hope that changes.
The National War on Drugs.
Like, yeah.
Those guys.
Childish Gambino.
There are a lot of good people
Jay-Z. Who won this year.
I mean,
finally,
a good artist won this year.
Good artist,
sure.
Like,
yeah.
People are kind of like shitting on Bruno too, but actually like a lot of songs on that
record. He killed it this year.
Like,
I mean, he was talented.
And I think people sometimes too, like, they like criticize, like, oh, there are 5 writers on that song. Like, the majority of the time, like, that song is probably better than the song you can.
But I also think that it's like, you know, it's the reason why you can't give awards to art, because art's subjective, you know? And I think that in itself is already something that's like a pretty, like, it's a pretty tough thing. Like, you can't, you know, all art is subjective art. And the thing, like, you know, knowing about kind of being living in like LA and being in the music industry, is that like things that I've kind of heard and learned over the last few years is that a lot of people, you know, have campaigns, they'll campaign. They did it with the Oscars. They do it with the Oscars too. They campaign for people that are on the committee and like wine and dine, be like, hey, you really should vote for this, it's really great. And like, so it's kind of, you're kind of like, okay, like, it's, you know, it's not as pure as it could be.
Well, if you label something too, it's like there are winners, but then there are also then now losers too. So what is the point of the whole thing? I mean,
right.
You shouldn't be a winner or loser.